Hi folks, and welcome to another video. This is one of the HS P505s in pieces. Unfortunately, I got a bit caught out with this one. I ended up disassembling it to a further degree than I'd have liked, because there's two pins, one here and one here, and they are soldered through to the circuit board here and here. So it wasn't until I'd actually desoldered those that the circuit board would come away, and I wound up undoing more screws than I really should have. So the screws that I did take apart are up here, and that's quite a few bits and pieces that I've got to put back on. Oh joy. Yeah, so here we are with the unit in pieces. This is also missing. It's missing a micro switch, because when I bought this off eBay, they said that the play button wasn't working, and sure enough, the micro switch itself proved to be faulty. So I'm tracking down another micro switch, which I think I've got. I mean, I've got a few coming from Fleabay, and hopefully they'll be the right type to do the job. May need a bit of adjustment, but hey ho. You can't get exactly the parts that you need these days, and especially as I haven't actually got a service manual for the P505, I was pretty much guessing as to what the heck I was doing. The belt seems to be in reasonable nick, possibly could do with being a bit tighter. I've got another one to change it out with, but what the hey, let's do that now. Or I got it open, if I can find the damn things, that is. They're in here somewhere. Here they are. So, this one looks as if it's, rather than a two spindles, I think it's one motor here, and the polarity of the motor is reversed in order to achieve the other direction. Yeah, when I got this one off eBay, it said that it wasn't responding to the play button, so I knew that I had to take it apart and do something to it. While I've got it apart, obviously, all these various capacitors of different values are going to have to be replaced. There's actually only about three different values here. We have 220 at 4 volts, 100 at 2 volts, and 220 at 2 volts. So some of those are already on their way, and I'll replace those before I put it back together. So I'm just going to take a moment to try and memorize how this goes. And we shall take this off. And comparing it to the new one, yes, it has stretched. So yeah, we're going to replace that one with this one, which went over there, around there, around there, and around there. So yeah, that's the new belt. There is a screw which I believe is it's one of the screws around here somewhere. When this is actually put over, something is in charge of something else. I think this is actually in charge of the direction, this particular section here. I think that's in charge of the direction. I'm not going to mess around with that too much. But, one of the things that we have to alter is the motor speed, which will, I think it's on the circuit board under here. That's the motor, and that's the motor speed there. So what I'll be able to do is, you can't actually see this because you're too far up that way. There's a connection for the motor, and these, when it's back together, this wire rests here and is stuck down. And this here adjusts the motor speed. So when I've got it all back together in one piece, what I'm going to have to do is just play the 3000 hertz tape and adjust this until it is actually putting out 3000 hertz. You can see here that these are the two sections that sit on top of the pins that will just come straight through there. And when I actually go to the extent of putting this in place, I don't want to do that now because it'll just do that when I'm ready. You know, if I start putting things in and out too much, then it will it'll bugger things up and weaken things. So you can see pretty much there's one ribbon cable here, which goes to the head, which is on the underside. Let's just reverse this over, and you can see what's going on in here. You can see the tape head. One thing you probably can't see is there's actually four connections here, and those go to each of the heads. In fact, there should be five. Oh yes, there are five. And you can see the common and the head, and that there's two heads for each direction. Well, it's one head and there's two pickups for each direction, so there's four pickups in all, and all go to a common, and those carry the signal to the circuit board, where it then does its job. This brown cable here is normally soldered to there, and from the looks of some of the solder joints on here, somebody had been in here before to try and solve the microswitch issue, and obviously didn't work. So yeah, that's pretty much how this is put together. There are a few switches on the side. I'm just going to turn this back over again very gently. One of the switches is actually here, and it's mechanical, which deals with forward and rewind. You can either jog, I think partially, and then it'll spring back if you attempt to jog it, or you can push it all the way over and it will continue on a forward or reverse, whichever it's going. You then have some switches, two here, and there's two at the side here, and those deal with various functions. What do they deal with? We've got dynamic loudness, remote, then on the side we have Dolby and tapes type selector, and that's what these are all about. So yeah, just gotta wait now. Fortunately, I think the microswitch is coming from within the UK, so the new microswitch should be here in a few days, probably next week sometime in the middle of, and the capacitors are already on their way from the US, so I'm expecting those to arrive and require require some sort of attention from me. The eject switch is just almost falling off, so just let's just put that right. And yeah, then I can swap out the capacitors, which I'm probably going to attempt to film, even though I'm probably going to make a right mess of it. And I've already taken pictures of these, and other thing that I'll show you is this, by the way, is a magnetic board, so when the screws are out, I know, for example, that these are the external screws, and I know the positions of them. Yes, fortunately, they are the same screw. These are other screws for the sides. Thank you, stay on there. And I've put them on there according to position. And those are the sections, the screws for this unit down here, which is the external power receiver. So yeah, it's going to be fun putting it all back together. But one of the other faults with this is one of the common faults, which is that it's getting quiet on one of the channels. The other thing that I'm doing is I was given a notepad, a notebook for Christmas by a friend, and that's what it's pretty much being used for right now, which is to draw a copy of the circuit board, which capacitors are where, and what their values are, and what the polarity is. So if I bugger all this up, all I've got to do is revert to my diagrams. and I'll know exactly where I am. We've got the two irons. This is the Antex XS25, and this was needed to get the larger, more powerful joints off. But when it comes to the capacitors, I'll be using the temperature control station with a TC50, and that's roughly what I'm going to be doing. So yeah, it's going to take possibly another week or so for the various bits and pieces to arrive. Let's just yeah, that's looking better. That's definitely looking better. Okay, I see. Which of these two goes depends on where the cogs are selected. So now that I've just run that a bit, yeah, that looks a bit better. But yeah, I might actually try and sort this out a little, because it's a square belt, and yeah, square belts need to sit square. So I'm probably just going to make sure that these go around and go around properly and don't twist. Like this one is actually twisted, so that's twisted there, so I'm going to twist it back in that direction and bring it around. Is that better? Yeah, I think that's better. Okay. Just seat it properly. It's still twisted. So yeah, I mean, this is one of these things that I'm going to have to do when I've got the camera out of the way, and I can get right up close and see what the hell's going on. And so that's one of the things that I'm going to be doing. yeah, see you on the next video. This will probably, gotta wait for the parts to arrive, which should be middle of next week sometime, and we'll give it a shot. See you then.